Okay.
So we're back. And I've had this guy overnight in the refrigerator. And that really seems to have been a bad move. But we're going to try to work with what we've got. And I've misplaced my razor somewhere. So I've got this box cutter that is less than desirable, which is unfortunate because this is the hard part. I hate to have to throw all this work away if I mess up the head. But I've got to get this done now. I was gonna load the video on YouTube, but I had some problems doing that. Hopefully, I'll get that fixed today. Wish I wouldn't have run out of daylight yesterday. In the future, I would not recommend stopping in the middle and refrigerating the project because it's detrimental to the whole process, evidently. Did not help the situation for the squirrel right here. Plus, I had it in the borax and it's already starting to dry out. I did start work on the armature, which is made out of floral foam. Hopefully, it's the right size. May turn out to be a one-time project, guys, because I'm going to be very upset if I have to throw this away. There's a lot of fat around the neck area, and it's kind of difficult to tell where I need to be cutting. Hopefully, it will not lead to another hole. see how there's a lot of flesh sticking to it. I just tried to pick him up by his tail a while ago and pulled some hairs out. I hope that's not going to mess things up too bad. Should be coming up pretty soon. Oh, here we are at the ear. Another difficult bit. To fill that in with some clay because it looks like there's gonna be a little bit of hole where his ear was. And I keep saying he, but this is a female. Not in much of as much of a mood to work on this today as I was when I first started, but again, it's got to be done. Okay, see how the ears are there. Looks like the skin's already coming loose from around the skull. I'm not really having to cut it too much, actually. Not a very pleasant kind of a feeling, really. Like I said, the way this guy died is that, struck by a car. It's amazing what kind of trauma an animal can go through and still have a skull intact. Which I'll show it to you when I get it out of here. Not the skull, but still covered in the muscle structure. Looks like we've got the eye coming up, which is a lot farther down than you would think it would be. And the face is coming off surprisingly well, a lot easier than the feet. And looks like the eye is right in here. Don't want to mess up this area because eyes are very important. That's how you can tell if something's dead or alive, looking at the eyes. And we don't want him to look too horrible. I figured the eyes were going to be the most difficult bit, but so far I've found it to be more difficult around the legs. It's helping to just stay very close to the muscle structure instead of cutting towards the skin to cut toward the body of the animal. And it really helps if you have a good sharp blade. It's coming quite easily, actually. I'm just wondering about stitching up those holes and how I'm going to work out the mouth and eye area. concerned about whether my armature is the right size. I should have measured, but I didn't, being me and how I hate measuring. I just eyeballed it out. Ironically, I'm doing the eyeball right now. And it's kind of attached really good to where the eyeball's at. And there's a membrane around it that I don't want to get too close to the skin. So I've got some extra stuff hanging around here. Looks like I'm cutting the outside of the eyeball off, but I see that the eyelid is intact in here. If you can see that little dark area, is an eyelid, and he really looks quite dead now. The way his eyes look is just awful. Okay, now we got the bit around the eye on that one side. And I'm wondering what I'm going to do when it comes to the mouth. I'm thinking maybe it'll be similar to the eye. Like there'll be a little membrane around it that I can kind of work with. I just can't wait till everybody sees this video and thinks I'm such a sick weirdo, but I think it's an interesting project, if nothing else. Sorry guys about my mood, I'm just not feeling doing this today. We gotta push on through, don't we? Okay, there's some breakage in there. Either that or I just felt the teeth glide together and it was pretty gross. It's trying to hold on here at the muzzle a lot. And it's unclear where I really need to be cutting. There's a white area that separates where the skin is attached to the muscle, and it helps to aim for that. See here? Well, here, I don't know how well you can see considering this lighting. I just don't know where I need to be aiming anymore. Okay, it's gonna be like around the feet that you're really close to the bone. So you have to be very, very careful. Connective tissue going on here. All here at the mouth. See, his jaw's been broken, I think. But I don't know a lot about squirrels. Maybe I can just slide it down. Coming over the nose. This part has not had a lot of attention in the videos, and that's not good because this is important. Oh, I see where the skull's been broken now. All around the eye area. Guess I'm gonna just have to cut in to this part here. This looks so pitiful at this point. Maybe it'll become more clear once I get this off what I'm supposed to do next. Some pulling. Oh, okay. That is terrifying. Look at this squirrel's teeth. Oh my gosh. He's like Predator. Scary. Can't believe that. And there's not really much to the top teeth. See? Looks like one's been broken out. But mostly it's bottom teeth. Really strange. Okay. Looks like that might be right about the right size. Upset if this does not work. It's been in the borax and I should have turned this the right way before I let it stay stored. Right way. It's not going that easily. Just gotta be careful. If you've ever made a stuffed toy. This is very similar. I knew I shouldn't have left it like this. Got some hair coming off. Have a squirrel with an inside out foot. That's what I've got. Before I do all the work on turning this out, I need to make sure that face looks all right, but I'm scared to look at it, to tell you the truth. It's already done a lot of shrinking, and it's hard to get this foot out of here. There it goes. I ripped him a little bit, but there he goes. All right. The little foot. Okay. That one. I'm so scared to turn that face the right way. A lot of blood got on him. Her. A lot of blood got on her. This is just so strange. Oh, well, not too bad. Looks pretty good. A little squirrel face here. I guess I'm going to wash them with some Dawn detergent, and I'm going to get back to you on hopefully the final part of this video.